Let's go ahead and do another example. And this time our polynomial is going to be degree 4 and our divisor is going to be y minus 1. So we are of the correct form, x minus a. Obviously we're using y's instead of x's, but that's not a problem. We are subtracting off the value of 1, and so our a is 1. So note in my synthetic division I have listed outside there in the divisor position the value a of 1. And then I also have listed the coefficients of our degree 4 polynomial, which is our dividend. Note that y to the fourth is 1 y to the fourth, so hence the coefficient of 1. And then note that we're also missing a degree 1 term. So in that case, the coefficient for that degree 1 term is 0, so we need to make sure we account for that when we list our coefficients there in the dividend position. And so so you can see that 1, negative 5, negative 3, 0, 10 are my coefficients. And then from there, the process is the same as the last example we did, but I did want to draw your attention to the fact that you should want to make sure that your polynomials are written in descending order, and that if any terms are missing, as far as you know, you're descending in power, and any term is missing, you want to account for that with a zero placeholder. So from there, we'll go ahead and do this example, and we're going to start off just like we always do by pulling down that first coefficient under our dividend, and then we draw our line. Anything below the line is going to multiply by our a. Anything above the line is going to add or combine with our coefficients. So starting off, we have 1 times 1. We get 1. Combine negative 5 and 1, we get negative 4. Take that negative 4 and multiply it by our a. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4. Combine negative 3 and negative 4, you get negative 7. Take your negative 7 and multiply it by a. Negative 7 times 1 is negative 7. Combine that with my 0, I get negative 7. Take the negative 7 and multiply it by my 1, we get negative 7. Combine that with 10, the result is a positive 3, which is our remainder. And note that, again, this was y minus 1. And it was y to the fourth minus 5 y to the third minus 3 y squared plus 0 y plus 10. And so when we do that division, we take a y minus 1 and divide it into that y to the fourth polynomial. We're going to get a degree 3 polynomial, so 1 degree less than our dividend. And it's going to start with coefficient 1. So it's going to be 1 y cubed, and then just go in descending order of powers at that point. So minus 4 y to the second, minus 7 y, minus 7. That's our quotient. And then since it's a positive remainder, I'll put plus, and then I put my remainder over my divisor, which is y minus 1, and that is our complete answer.